Hello students, today we are going to discuss double fertilization. So double fertilization occurs in angiospermic plants, means flowering plants. So it was discovered by Nostrin in the liliaceous plants like Lilium and Fritillaria. Here it is pollen grain, pollen tube, style, stigma, triple fusion, ovary, synergids, micropyle and syngamy. This is micropylar end, this is chalazal end, okay? So we are going to discuss the process of double fertilization. After pollen grain has reached on the surface of stigma, this is surface of stigma, it germinates and forms pollen tube. This is tube like structure is called pollen tube, which penetrates the stigma, which penetrates the stigma style ovary chamber and then enters ovule. The growth of pollen tube is guided by chemicals. So who will provide these chemicals? The chemicals are provided by synergids. The growth of pollen tube is guided by the chemicals secreted by the synergids. It usually enters ovule. It enters ovule through, what is the name of this end? It is micropylar end. So enters ovule through the micropyle. It is termed as porogamy, but in some case it is found to enter through chalaza. This is chalazal end, so it is found to enter from chalazal end. So name of this process is chalazogamy. And in some plants, by piercing intugments, these are the intugments, means outer layer, inner layer, outer intugment, inner intugment. So sometimes pollen tube enters ovule by piercing the intugments called mesogamy. Finally it penetrates embryo sac of ovule through micropylar end. The pollen tube carrying male gametes penetrates in one of the synergids. Watery contents of synergids are absorbed by pollen tube, which then ruptures and releases the content, including the two non-motile male gametes. Non-motile means immobile. As non-motile male gametes are carried through hollow pollen tube, it is known as symphonogamy. Why symphonogamy? As non-motile male gametes are carried through hollow means poker, hollow pollen tube, it is known as symphonogamy. That ensures fertilization to take place. Now there are two processes carried out in double fertilization. First is syngamy, second is triple fusion. Syngamy is the fusion of haploid male gamete with haploid female egg. Female egg haploid with haploid male gamete. The process is called syngamy to produce a diploid zygote, whereas in triple fusion secondary nucleus producing primary endosperm nucleus, PEN, primary endosperm nucleus, that develops into triploid endosperm. What get unite in triple fusion? Secondary nucleus and male gamete. एंड प्रोडक्ट इज प्राइमरी एंडोस्पर्म न्यूक्लियस दैट डेवलप्स इनटू ट्रिप्लॉइड एंडोस्पर्म. द जाइगोट डेवलप्स इनटू एन एम्ब्रियो. सिंगामी इज टाइप ऑफ जनरेटिव फर्टिलाइजेशन वेयर एज ट्रिपल फ्यूजन इज टाइप ऑफ वेजिटेटिव फर्टिलाइजेशन. Both the male gametes participate and therefore it is described as or called double fertilization. Why it is called in double fertilization? Because both the male gametes participate and therefore it is described as double fertilization. So what is the significance of double fertilization? It is a unique feature of angiosperms. It ensures that the parent plant invests a seed with a food store only if egg is fertilized. Diploid zygote develops into an embryo which consequently develops into a new plant. A triploid PEN. PEN means what? Primary endosperm nucleus. Develops into nutritive endosperm tissue. It restores the diploid condition by fusion of haploid male gamete with haploid female gamete through syngamy. It also helps to avoid polyembryony. So you have to remember pollen grain. This is covering of stigma. Pollen grain comes to stigma, then through pollen tube male gametes are reaching to the ovule where triple fusion and syngamy processes are carried out. So both male gametes are present in the development process, so process is called double fertilization. So keep studying, keep watching. Thank you.